I'm Ariel Noor.
And I'm Jake Brown. Welcome to Hawk Talk. Homecoming tickets are now on sale at break and lunch. The cost this week is $40 with ASB and $50 without. Single tickets are half price. Remember, both ID cards must be presented to buy tickets. Guest passes for this dance are available at break or lunch in the finance office.
There is an Encore Club meeting at lunch in the theater today. All Encore Club members must bring their Encore Club cards in order to get into the meeting.
This week's Athlete of the Week is a girl on the golf team. She had shown great dedication over the past few weeks, and she works hard to encourage her teammates. Congratulations to Elizabeth Brider.
Speaking of athletics, here's Kylie Hatch and Matt West to give us an update on sports.
Thank you, Ariel, and welcome to El Dorado Sports. I'm Matt.
And I'm Kylie, and here's your sports.
In football, our team is bye this week, but that doesn't stop them from falling from their rigorous practice schedule. El Dorado is currently 4-1 in preseason, going into their first league game next week against Villa Park at Fred Kelly Stadium at El Medina High School. Our team is currently ranked 10th in county and hopes to advance that number. Coming off their first century championship season ever, our Hawks hope to defend this title and bring home a CIF championship.
And in girls' golf, our team is being held high and led by seniors Sam Norris and Allegra Kessler. Allegra also holds the team's best putting average for only 19 putts per round. Our girls play Tustin at Tustin Ranch Golf Club today at 2:30.
In cross country, our team this year is under new management with Coach Beckman. The team is working hard and training nonstop to leave the competition in the dust. Senior John Lashana is running very hard this year and is constantly placing in major events. The next meet is at the Mount Sac Invitational on Saturday.
In girls' tennis, our ladies are 14-4 and recently walked away with a first place in the first serve tournament, defeating Modern Day in semifinals and Rosary in the final match to claim the title. Our team is being led by junior Julie Lazar, who has only lost two of a total of 54 matches. The team also stands with our number one doubles team of Jessica Cyrus and Tara Prancevic. Our Hawks play their next match against Villa Park today at 3 o'clock.
In girls volleyball, our team is currently ranked 6th in county and has a record of 9-2 and is undefeated in league with 2 wins. They hope to take league this year and breeze through CIF. The next match is against Villa Park, today at Villa Park, at 3:15.
In boys water polo, our boys are working hard to make the playoffs under the help of senior Aaron Steiger. The next match for our Hawks is tomorrow against Fullerton, here at 6 o'clock. Thank you for tuning into sports, and back to you, Ariel, with the rest of our news.
Thanks, guys. Hey, Jake, do you know what it means for El Dorado to be named a Blue Ribbon School?
No, I have no idea.
Well, neither do a lot of people. Here's a tasty treat from our friends in the office and faculty members about our highly acclaimed Blue Ribbon School.
Over the years, El Dorado High School has received many different awards. Recently, El Dorado was named a National Blue Ribbon School. We talked to Principal Wilkins to find out more.
The Blue Ribbon Award is given to schools that have been named State Distinguished Schools, and it's an honor bestowed on them by the U.S. Department of Education.
We asked Ms. Stark what this recognition means.
An applauding compliment to the students, the teaching faculty, and even to the administration on this campus.
We asked Spanish teacher Dan DuPont what's the best part of teaching at a Blue Ribbon School.
Para mí, lo mejor de trabajar aquí en EDHS es los estudiantes, sin duda.
Finally, we decided to ask Mrs. Gross her opinion.
And I think what Blue Ribbon really means to me is recognizing the quality of kids and the quality of teachers and staff people and the quality of programs we have. A Blue Ribbon school is a school you ought to take pride in, and I'm really, really proud of this school.
Thank you to all who made it possible for our school to win this award. Friday is the last day to sign up for the PSAT. To sign up, come to the finance office after school only. The cost is $19. Homecoming court nominations are happening this week. Place your nomination for your class at break and lunch in front of the activities office. Nominations end tomorrow, so make yours today. There will be a Science and Nature Club meeting today at lunch. Come to the Ken Penn's Botany Center for some barbecue and to get information on the first trip. Please bring your $5 dues.
Know anyone in drama? Chances are they'll be starring in the school's first play of the year, Burial at Thebes. Check out this behind-the-scenes look at the production of this show.
Well, I think my favorite scene would probably have to be the opening scene with me and Emily, who plays as Mimi.
The story's good, the message is good. Also, for sophomores, it's going to be some extra credit, I think, because it is Antigone and you have to read it, so come see it. Extra credit.
So this is the first play where we actually really have to work out and stuff. So I'm trying to lose weight. He's trying to gain muscle mass in his arms. We're trying to meet each other halfway.
He's hard to lift. He's a big guy. And it's a little tough. But if I do actually get enough like weightlifting in, it's going to be a really fun scene to shoot.
You won't want to miss this great production. College Funding Seminars, Attention Juniors and Seniors. On Saturday, October 14th from 10 to 11 a.m. at Esperanza High School, there will be a College Funding Seminar. Reservations are free and recommended. Check the weekly bulletin for details. The members of the Thespian Troupe 199 will be having their annual foot fundraiser, Friends of Our Theater, tomorrow night at 7 p.m. in the theater. The cost of this event, which includes performances, dessert, and an opportunity drawing, is $10.
So, what did you guys do this weekend? Well, three of El Dorado students, Courtney Ray, Aaron Keller, and Joey O'Connell, did a bit of off-roading. Take a look at what they did.
I'm Courtney.
I'm Joey.
I'm Aaron.
And this is our hobby.
What makes me want to off-road? Showing people that my truck can go the distance. Down in Mississippi where the sun beats down from the sky. They give it up and they give it up and they give it up, but they never ask why. Daddy was a rolling, rolling stone. I feel good, but I feel a little pissed when I get stuck or something. That sucks. Twice, both times today.
Stay tuned next time for other weekend adventures and more El Dorado news. You stay golden, El Dorado.